Now, reverse charge, this just to make you understand, one thing that we have to understand from government's point of view, government wants GST. And for that GST, government wants everybody who is supposed to have GST number. We'll see in the next slide how that GST number is obtained when a dealer or person is liable for taking that GST registration. But to bill GST amount in the bill, one has to have registration. And after registration, that person will have GSTIN number on his invoice, which we call tax invoice. And in that, he will charge GST to the buyer. And that will be given to the government, state and central government or union territory after collection or after a certain period of time that we'll see also what is time of supply of GST to the government, state, union territory or central government. So from this, it is very clear that suppose the person is not having GST number. Understand one thing, government wants GST. And for that purpose, now this is not applicable, it is actually kept in abeyance. The government wishes to apply this, but since there are so many complexities and then now this tension of COVID for last few months, government has postponed that application of reverse charge, but it will come in a few months time. But let us understand what a reverse charge. Reverse charge is a case where the person who is receiving supply of goods or services is having GST number, and the person who is giving the supply of goods and services is not having GST number. Now, as I told you, GST is to be billed in the bill by the supplier, means seller. Now, when the seller is not having GST number, because seller is not registered, then GST will not be applied in the bill. So the buyer will not pay GST to the seller, and seller will not pay that to the government. But as I said, government wants GST. So under this reverse charge mechanism, what government has done? Government has said, when the supplier of the goods and services is not having GST number, so GST is not levied, the person who is receiving the supply of goods and services, means buyer, he has to charge GST to the seller, which seller was supposed to charge to the buyer. So buyer will charge GST to the seller because buyer is having GST number. Then buyer will collect that from seller. While making the payment, he will deduct that. And that buyer will pay to the state government or union territory, GST, UT GST, or it will be paid to the central government in the name of CGST and IGST. So reverse charge is applicable when the buyer is having GST number and the seller is not having GST number for supply of goods and services. So seller cannot bill it to the buyer. In that case, buyer has to bill it to the seller, and then that is called reverse charge, and that GST is then charged by the buyer, collected by the buyer and paid by the buyer to the government. That is reverse charge mechanism.